What's up, guys? EnderUnknown here. I'm back for a very quick tutorial for episode 5 of text-based dungeon game. Yay, or adventure game. I was requested to do a video on, like, text animations. And these are technically not animations. I'm going to clarify that immediately. They just make the text look more flashy. And I'm only doing one today because that's the one I'm doing, the one that was suggested. It was a typewriter style look to our game. And the same person also suggested music and sound effects, so I'm going to probably be covering that next weekend. But anyways, let's get started. We are going to be working at the bottom of our program class. So we're going to start by creating a new function or method, so public static, because we want it to be accessed anywhere and we don't want to use a reference, so we can just use program as the reference. Void, because we're not returning anything, and we're just going to call it print. We're going to want to have two arguments for this. The first is going to be a string called the text, and the second is going to be an integer or an int called the speed. So using this, we're going to take a for each loop, which we can use tab to insert, tab, and we're going to want to use each char, and the variable name C is what I'm going to use, in text. So for every character in text, we're going to do some stuff. We're going to want to do console.write, not write line, just write C. Because if you use write line, it's going to look kind of funny. I mean, you could try it. I'm not going to because of time constraints. And then we're going to want to do system.threading.thread.sleep speed. Now, here's something to note about speed. The higher the speed integer is actually going to mean the longer this thing is going to sleep. So, maybe speed's a bad name. It's in milliseconds, and we're actually going to have speed have a default. So, the default speed is going to be like 40, I think. Then, after the for each loop, we're going to want it to bump down a line, just like the console.write line. So, I'm practicing the shortcuts, so we're just going to do console.writeline. That'll just bump it down a blank line, or onto a new line. So this is all that our print function needs, and now would be the fun process of translating all the console.write lines to the print. But I'm not going to do that for the sake of this video. I'm just going to change the these two, the ones that we see when we load it up. So print and print. Oh, and this 70 was actually from my experiment. I forgot to delete that. So 70 is going to be the duration in milliseconds that it'll take to print this out. We're going to probably want to change that. So 40 is the default. We're going to want this one to be a little bit faster, so I guess we'll do 60. And then, so if we put the second argument in the function, it's going to override the 40. If we don't, it's just going to use the default. So that's all I'm going to do. You are welcome to change as many or as little of these as you like, but I'm just going to use these two. So let's go into the program, and I will show you them working. Okay, because my recording software isn't fast enough to start before the thing's done, really, I had to add a little like read key in front of it, but so that it stops before I press a key. But this is it running in action. You can see the bottom text is being printed faster. So this, again, technically isn't an animation, but it is a very cool text effect. But yeah, pretty simple. Next week is likely going to be sounds. That's all I have for you guys today, so unless you have any suggestions, which I would appreciate if you left them in the comments, I've been really appreciating the support I've been getting on my videos recently. My subscriber count has been going up, and my views are going up, and I really appreciate the support that I've been getting. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and Ender out.